In this video, we're going to finish out the distance formula free CUDA software geometry worksheet. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. We're finding the distance between each pair of points. And unlike the previous section, we are not rounding. So real quickly, the distance formula is d equals the square root of the change in x, or the change in the horizontal distance, x2 minus x1 squared, and we're adding that to the change in vertical direction, y2 minus y1 squared. And it's the square root of both those quantities squared and then summed. Let's look at number 13. In number 13, you can see that there is no change in the x direction. We are not moving horizontally, we're only moving vertically. So distance is really easy to calculate. We can just count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The distance between these two points is 5. And the distance is essentially the length of the line. So you can see that this y value is a positive 3, whereas this y value is a negative 2. 3 minus negative 2 is 3 plus 2, which is 5. And the square root of 5 squared is 5. Moving on to number 14, x1, y1 will be 0, negative 1. x2, y2, we will have as 2, 0. So when we calculate distance, we'll get the square root of x2 minus x1 squared, which is 2 minus 0. Squared, and we're adding that to y2 minus y1, which is 0 minus negative 1, and since we're subtracting a negative, that's the same as adding a positive. So 0 plus 1 squared. So distance is going to equal 2 minus 0, which is 2 squared, plus 0 plus 1, which is 1 squared. So we have the square root of 2 squared plus 1 squared, which is the square root of 4 plus 1, since 2 squared is 4 and 1 squared is 1, and that's going to be equivalent to the square root of 5. So the square root of 5 is the distance from point 0, negative 1 to 2, 0. And number 15, x1 and y1 will be 0, negative 5, and x2, y2 will be 5, 1. So plugging those into our formula, so we'll have distance equals the change in x, so 5 minus 0 squared plus the change in y, 1 minus negative 5, which is 1 plus 5 squared. And we're taking the square root of both of those quantities squared and added together. So that's going to be the square root of 5 minus 0, which is 5 squared plus 1 plus 5, which is 6 squared. The square root of 5 squared plus 6 squared is going to be equal to the square root of 25 plus 36, which 25 plus 36 is 61. So for number 15, our answer is the square root of 61. So for number 16, we have negative 3, 3, and we're going to call that x2, y2, and we have x1, y1 as 2, 2. So when we take the square root of x2 minus x1, we're doing negative 3 minus 2. That squared plus y2 minus y1, which is 3 minus 2 squared. Negative 3 minus 2 is negative 5. We're squaring that, and then we have 3 minus 2, which is 1, and we're squaring that. So the square root of negative 5 squared plus 1 squared is the square root of negative 5 squared, which is 25, plus 1 squared, which is 1. So for number 16, we have the square root of 25 plus 1, which is the square root of 26. And that's the distance between the endpoints of this segment. So essentially, the distance of the segment. For number 17, we have one point as 3, 5, and the other point as 4, negative 4. My x1, y1, I'll use as 4, negative 4, and my x2, y2, I'll have as 3, and 5. So x2 is 3 minus x1, which is 4, that's squared, plus y2, which is 5, minus y1, which is negative 4, And since we're subtracting a negative, it's the same as adding a positive. So 5 plus 4 squared. So just as long as you keep the subtraction the same. So since we're subtracting 4 from 3, we must subtract negative 4 from 5. So it doesn't necessarily matter which point we start with. It just matters that we're subtracting the same x-coordinate as we do y-coordinate. So now we have the square root of 3 minus 4, which is negative 1, squared, plus 5 plus 4, which is 9 squared. So we have the square root of negative 1 squared is 1, plus 9 squared is 81. So this is going to be equal to the square root of 82. And the last graph is number 18. We have points 1, 5, and 2, negative 2. So I'm going to start with 1 minus 2, which means I have to do 5 minus negative 2. So 1 minus 2 for x2 minus x1, that's squared, and I'm adding that to 5 minus negative 2, which is 5 plus 2, and that's squared. So I have the square root of 1 minus 2, which is negative 1, that is squared, plus 5 plus 2, which is 7 squared. So I have the square root of 1 squared, which is 1, plus 7 squared, which is 49. That leaves me with the square root of 50. However, I can simplify the square root of 50, unlike the other square roots we've already done. For the square root of 50, I know that 25 goes into 50 two times. So I can write this as the square root of 2 times 25, which we know that 25 is 5 squared. So I can write this as the square root of 2 times 5 squared, which will allow me to pull out that 5 since the square root of a number squared cancels out that exponent of 2. So my final answer will be 5 times the square root of 2. And if you need help with simplifying square roots, please feel free to go to my tutorial section or go to the review of algebra section in the CUDA software where I've already gone over the practice problems for that worksheet. I'll leave a link to the description of both of those below. Now, continuing on. And for the sake of all of these, so that I don't have to label each of them, I'll do x1, y1 as my first coordinates and x2, y2 as my second coordinates. So for this, I'll have the square root of negative 5 minus 0 squared plus negative 1 minus negative 2 or plus 2 squared. That's going to give me the square root of negative 5 minus 0, which is negative 5 squared plus negative 1 plus 2 is 1 squared. So that'll leave me with negative 5 squared, which is 25. Plus 1 squared is 1, so I have the square root of 25 plus 1, which is the square root of 26. For number 20, I have the square root of negative 5 minus 6 squared plus negative 1 minus 4 squared. Negative 5 minus 6 is negative 11. We're squaring that quantity. Negative 1 minus 4 is negative 5. And we're also squaring that quantity. So negative 11 squared is 121, and negative 5 squared is 25. So we have the square root of 121 plus 25, which is going to give us the square root of 146. In number 21, I have 9 minus 3 squared and 10 minus 8 squared. I'm adding those together and taking the square root of that entire quantity. So I have the square root of 9 minus 3, which is 6 squared, plus 10 minus 8, which is 2 squared. That's going to give me the square root of 36 plus 4. Since 6 squared is 36 and 2 squared is 4. Adding 36 to 4 will give me 40, square root of 40. However, I know that 40 can be simplified because 4 goes into 40 evenly and 4 is a perfect square. So I'm going to rewrite this square root as the square root of 2 squared, since that's 4 times 10, and 4 times 10 is 40. So that's going to equal 2 times the square root of 10. So 2 times the square root of 10 is my final solution for number 21. For number 22, I have the square root of x2 minus x1, which is 9 minus 10 squared, plus y2 minus y1, which is negative 4 minus 1 squared. So that's going to be the square root of 9 minus 10, which is negative 1 squared, plus negative 4 minus 1, which is negative 5 squared. So I'll have the square root of negative 1 squared, which is 1, plus negative 5 squared, which is 25. So the square root of 1 plus 25 is going to be the square root of 26. And that cannot be simplified, so the square root of 26 is my solution in number 22. For number 23, I'm going to do negative 6 minus negative 8, so that'll be plus 8, and then I'll square that, and then I'll add that to 7 minus 10, that quantity squared, and take the square root of the entire thing to find the distance. So from there, I'll get negative 6 plus 8, which is a positive 2. We're squaring that quantity and adding it to 7 minus 10, which is negative 3, and we're squaring that quantity. So the square root of 2 squared plus negative 3 squared is equal to the square root of 4 plus 9. And the square root of 4 plus 9 is going to give us the square root of 13. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 24. I have that distance equals the square root of x2 minus x1, 8 plus 5, that's squared, plus negative 4 minus 6, y2 minus y1 squared. So distance is going to equal 8 plus 5, which is 13, squaring that, plus negative 4 minus 6, which is negative 10, squaring that quantity, so we have the square root of 13 squared, which is 169, plus negative 10 squared, which is 100. So for our final answer, we'll have the square root of 169 plus 100, which is the square root of 269. And that cannot be simplified, so the square root of 269 is our final solution in number 24. Now let's move on to our critical thinking questions. For number 25, we're to name a point that is the square root of 2 away from negative 1, 5. So they give us distance, and they give us one coordinate. Let's call this x1 and y1. So for our distance formula, we're going to plug those numbers in. So we'll have the square root of 2 equal to the square root of x2, which is our unknown, minus negative 1, so plus 1, squaring that, plus y2, which is our unknown, minus y1, which is 5, and that squared. Right off the bat, what I'm going to do is I'm going to square both sides. That'll get rid of my square root on both sides. So I'll have now that a positive is equal to x2 plus 1 squared plus y2 minus 5 squared. From here, what we have to do is figure out what two quantities add to give us 2, so right away we can see at least 4 different options. Let's go ahead and solve for when x2 plus 1 is equal to 1, and when y2 minus 5 is also equal to 1. And we know that 1 squared is equal to 1, and 1 squared plus 1 squared will be 1 plus 1, which will give us 2. So let's solve for x2 and y2 using that each of those quantities within the parentheses is equal to 1. So x2 plus 1 equals 1, and y2 minus 5 will also equal 1. Solving for x2, all we have to do is subtract 1 from each side to get that x2 is equal to 0. So 0 is our x coordinate for a point that is square root of 2 away from negative 1, 5. For y2 minus 5 equal to 1, all we have to do is add 5 to both sides. That'll give us that y2 is equal to 1 plus 5, which is 6. So 6 will be our y coordinate. So 0, 6 is one point that is square root of 2 away from negative 1, 5. So that's 1, 1. We could also have this term be negative 1 and this term be a positive 1. We could have this term be a negative 1 and this term be a positive 1. Or we could have both of them be negative 1. Since negative 1 squared is still equal to 1. So negative 1 squared plus 1 squared is 2. 1 squared plus negative 1 squared is 2. And negative 1 squared plus negative 1 squared is 2. So you can use either of those combinations to find a point. We used it when both 1s were positive. Go ahead and try it for when both 1s are negative and see which point you get. Leave a comment below with your answer and try the other two ways and let me know what you got for them as well. Ev, for number 26, it says to name a point that is between 50 and 60 units away from 7, negative 2, and state the distance between the two points. The easiest way to do this is to use either a vertical line or a horizontal line. If we're moving horizontally, we could just add a number between 50 and 60 to 7 while leaving y as the same number. If we were moving vertically, we could leave 7 the same and add a number between 50 and 60 to negative 2. Let's go ahead and move vertically. So 7 is not going to change, but let's say I want to add 52 to negative 2. Adding 52 to negative 2 will give me to a positive 50. So my new point is 750, so I named my point, and now I have to state the distance between, which, since I added 52, my distance is 52 units. So as always, like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, feel free to comment below with your other answer from number 25 or any questions that you may have. And that finishes out our distance formula worksheet on the CUDA software website.